I found this beetle wandering in our forest at the end of October. 2 weeks earlier, I'd spotted one in another part of our forest, and halfway summer, I'd found a dead specimen. The various species of the flower chafer subfamily are often mistaken for one another. Looking at information on the internet, I figured it could be either a Protaetia cuprea, a Cetonia aurata, or a Protaetia speciosissima. When posting a picture of the beetle on several forums and insect groups on the internet, it was identified as each of the possible options by different people. I uploaded the image to the observation.org database, and its automatic identification tool was 100% sure that it was a Cetonia aurata, or in English, a rose chafer. However, I was still leaning towards it being a Protaetia speciosissima, because we have the rose chafer on our terrain as well, and it didn't look quite like that one. For one thing, it seemed to be bigger. A beetle expert at the French environmental organization CPIE told me that it was a very late observation, but assured me that it belonged to the species of Protaetia cetonischema speciosissima. He explained to me that this can be determined, among others, from the following characteristics. Its big size, the compact shape, the uniformly brilliant green color, there being no white spot on the knees, and no marked depression on the elytra. An admin at the observation.org database confirmed this. It is definitely a Protaetia speciosissima. This species is among the biggest of the European flower chafers, with a size of up to 3 centimeters. In many European countries, this species is protected. It is fairly common in areas in France where there are old oak trees with lots of tree cavities present. They reside almost exclusively in old-growth oak forests. Even there, you don't get to see these beetles all that often, though, as they are mostly canopy dwellers. So I was very happy with this observation in our beautiful little forest.